you remember last year on the daily video blogs, I talked about planting sorghum versus corn in some of my food plots, and I had a lot of success with that last year. The deer didn't really touch it. Well, they won't touch it, at least here with the densities that we've got during the summer. They completely leave it alone, and then it gets to that dough stage where the seed just starts to fill in and get soft. Then they'll start working on it after that. But even on this farm, they weren't used to the sorghum yet, so they didn't hit it hard at that stage. They let it go all the way into the late season, which was perfect. So I am putting in more acres this year of sorghum. Last year I did, I think, about 7 or 8 acres. And this year I'm going to do more than 20 acres on the farm. So that's the project for today. It is the 13th of June, and you've got some time still for sorghum. Sorghum likes a really warm seed bed, so it doesn't do well until the soil gets real warm anyway. So you haven't lost a lot if you haven't got it in the ground already. It's going to grow faster and germinate quicker and get going, you know, on a faster timeline if you plant it now than if you'd have planted it earlier anyway. The steps in my plots this year include spraying it with the Kubota rigged up with the sprayer on it. And that does a really nice job. It's got the boomless sprayer, which covers roughly 30 feet of spread without having to drop out, you know, booms every time you come into a field. So we're going to hit it first with that, and this is going to be, you know, an initial burn down with just a little bit of residual with atrazine in the mix. But it's going to be more of a glyphosate 2,4-D crop oil and then a little bit of atrazine, and that should carry hopefully the sorghum into the point where it outcompetes the weeds. I'm using the RTP Genesis no-till drill for this, and it does a really, really good job with sorghum. That's what I used last year, and I've got 22.5-inch rows is what I'm planning on, because the drill is set up for 7.5-inch rows, but I'm blocking two and then leaving one open and then blocking two. So it gives me, you know, a really nice row width for you know, getting a lot of sunshine and you know, making the plants flourish. But you know, it does a nice job of putting the seed into the ground at the right depth. And that's the beauty of no-till versus tillage, is if I tilled this up, it would dry out, and then we would need a rain in order to get any kind of germination. But with the no-till, I can get germination and get this thing going even without any rains coming. So we'll bring you a little bit of action here on the video blog today and show you how we're putting sorghum into the ground, and hopefully this fall there'll be some good hunting over these plots.